Hey troops, Roxy here, and welcome to Roxy Plays Games, and welcome back to another episode of SimRail. Yes, we're going to continue with our playthrough. I was initially going to be doing a tutorial within the single player element, and I was going to do this one here, the ED250, but I'm actually going to postpone that, and the reason being is I actually want to jump into multiplayer, because I'm guessing that's what most people are wanting to do with this game anyway, rather than playing single player all the time. They want to actually get into the multiplayer element, which obviously is, in my opinion, one of the better parts of the sim. So that's what I'm going to do today, and I've got a couple of things that I wanted to point out as well, which I was someone put in a comment in my last video, so we'll come on to that. So yeah, I'll do that at a later date. So today we're going to do multiplayer. We'll do the same train because I wanted to point out a couple of things, and then next episode I'm going to do the dispatching, and then after that we'll see how we're going on from there. So without further ado, let's get in here. And there's something I want to show you as well, which is really, really cool that the devs have done. So when you go into multiplayer, you've got all of the different servers down here, and you've got various different ones: Chinese, Spanish, Polish, French, English, Italian. So there's lots of different ones, and there's four different regions. So you've got Europe, Asia, Australia, and North America. So you've got one server on North America, this one here. This is one I'm actually going to be jumping onto for this video. And the reason being is because obviously it's all live times, and it's going to be, it's 11:07 here in the evening. And it's going to be pitch black, and you won't be able to see anything. So yes, they're mainly European, with one Asian, one Australian, and one North American server. Right, so before I jump into the server that I want to jump into, if we go on to the European one, and we check, this is the one I normally go on to. As you can see here, we've got one driver and four traffic dispatchers. The French one's got seven drivers and 10 dispatchers. Now, as well as this, there is also a live Google map, very similar to anyone that's played ETS and ATS, where you can look at a map and see real people. Well, this is the same, and you can also see the AI or the bots as well. So if I quickly flick you over to this screen here, description below. What we're going to be doing though is we're going to be jumping onto the American server, which is English 3, if I remember. English 3 or EN3. There's no real people on this server, unfortunately, but like I say, if I go onto a server with people, it's going to be nighttime, so I won't get to see the scenery, which is a shame, but I will do one during the day. So once you've picked a server, you then choose whether you want to be a driver or dispatcher. We'll be doing this next episode. So we're going to go driver, and then you get to choose your train. So you've got various different ones. These are the 250s, the EIP. We've got the EC, which is these. I always thought these were just for cargo, but some of them are for passenger. You can actually, if you click on train, you can choose what you want. So we're going to click on passenger, so we only see passenger ones. TLK is very similar to this. This is the ones that we're going to be going for, the EN76. I think there's another variation of it as well. The 96, so 76 and 96, I think, is the two. I'm not sure if there's another variation. It seems to be 76 and 96, two different variations. Right, so when you click on these, it's giving you the train number. So 42926 reg. This here tells you this rolling stock number, whether it's passenger or whatever, how long's left on this scenario. So this one's only got 14 minutes left. Difficulty, they're all zero difficulty, required level zero, and it also tells you the route that this train is on. So some of them have got this one here, some of them have got this one here, slightly different route. So we are going to try and find a route that's about half an hour, 40 minutes long, ideally. 7 minutes. Oh, 38 minutes. Yes, we'll go for this one here. So 19955. Right, so if I flick you back over to this screen here. Take you back here is click play, and that's us good to go pretty much. Yeah, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe buttons and hit that notification bell so you know when new videos come out. Doesn't cost you a single penny, but does help my channel grow and reach more people, which will be greatly appreciated. Right, so when you... That was loud. When you... hold down a little touch. For now, I'll turn it up a little bit more in a second. So when you jump in, it will be automatically run by the bot. It says here auto, and all you've got to do is click on this to disable the bot. Right, something that I wanted to bring up, which was mentioned on my previous SimRail video. First of all, thank you, Chris Brown. It's a nice one. I'd not heard of this game, thanks. So yeah, that's the reason why it's always handy or nice if you can like and subscribe, because it does help the video get out to people that may not even know that this exists, and they're looking for this type of game. So thank you, Chris. But the two people I wanted to give a quick shout out and thanks is, excuse me if I pronounce this wrong, Panharabia, P-A-N-H-R-A-B-I-A, Panharabia. He says, actually, there is no need to turn off the cruise control to use 100% power when accelerating and braking. Please use the OPT plus and minus buttons on the cruise control panel. So basically what it was, as I said, this is the cruise control button. We'll bring that in a second. And then I was saying that you could click on these various set speeds or minus, plus and minus to increase or decrease the cruise control speed. But when you activate it, it will automatically be set at 50% power. And I said to set the power higher or lower, you have to take off the cruise control and then push this lever back or forwards, your drive speed or power. And you don't need to do that. Actually, all you need to do is click on this plus and minus button, and that will do it for you while the cruise control is on. So that is awesome, thank you. And Robert3579 says, cruise control power percentage is also shown on the screen next to the speed, which I didn't actually click or realize. So we're going to have a little look at that. How far are we from the station? I'm going to wait until we get into the station. I'll then take over, because when you click on this, it doesn't power everything off, but it kind of stops everything from working for a second, about 3 or 4 seconds, and then it kind of kicks back in again. Don't know why it does that, don't know why it's not automatic, but yeah, we'll just wait until we are in the station, and then I will get everything all switched on, ready to go. Let's turn some lights on in here, getting a bit dark. A quick sip of my cappuccino. Oh, that's good. Alright, you're approaching the station, thank you for that. Any time now would be nice, please. Thank you. If you stop before it says you can stop now, it won't count as you stopping, which I found out. I think I found out in the last episode, I can't remember. But yeah. Right, let's click on this. And double check that is actually... See how the power kind of goes off? Everything goes off. Don't know why that. And it kind of comes back in a second. You can hear it all clicking and stuff. There we go. So it's all back in. Right, we've got 2 minutes. Right, so cruise control, activate. Speed limit is 40. And here's the percentage flashing, which I didn't realize. So thanks, Robert. So basically, what... Panharabia was saying is, if you click on this, this will increase or decrease. There we go. 80, 90, 100. So I don't have to deactivate the cruise control and then increase the power on this to get the power up to 100%. We can do it with this. So it means that pretty much you can control everything from the from here for your speed. The only thing you need to use this for now, or use your plus and minus key, is just to do the initial set of, or initial start, just to get you up to about 4 or 5 kilometers an hour. Then you can release it and then the cruise control will kick in. So yeah, really, really cool. So thanks for that, guys, that's very, very helpful. Right, so I'm getting in the train. That's kind of cool that that actually happens. They walk in rather than just kind of warping in like some other train sim games do. Okie dokie, right, so let's have a quick look. Get my... I have got some music playing in the background. I'll put a link in the description to that as well. That's some music played or a Spotify channel by Total Eclipse, another YouTuber. I'll put a link in the description for that, so it's very, very cool. Right, let's close the doors. And let's get some speed going forwards. 2, 3, there we go. And that's enough. We've got another, we got an activation thing coming up in a second. The vigilance button. There it is. Right, and now we're up to 120 kilometers, so let's whack that up. And having 100% power just means we're going to get there a lot quicker, which is fantastic. I got 2 kilometers to the next station. And if we have a quick look over here. Approaching the station, so let's get some speed down. So we're going 60. Once I kind of get to about here, I'm going to hit 40. So I'm not crawling all the way in. I wouldn't say I've mastered it, but I kind of got used to it now. And as soon as it's ready to stop, that's when I'm going to hit the zero speed. Just like that. Fantastic, let's open the doors on the left hand side. Few people coming in. So yeah, the sim does look really, really good. Very, very impressed with it. All right, 120, increased speed. So you basically get points if you depart on time, if you arrive on time, and distance traveled, and you lose points for speeding and not sounding your horn when you need to and all that sort of stuff, so. But what I like most about this, obviously train sim games are all good, well some are better than others, but yeah, in general they're good. What I like about more about like this is the fact that it's multiplayer. You can play with friends and family and other people, strangers, and chat with them. It does have in-game chat over the radio, so basically you are physically talking through the radio, which is really, really cool. Right, we've got another station coming up. Get some braking done. Right, let's come to a stop. And that's just fantastic. We have lost connection for some unknown reason. Right, let me just get that sorted out. We may need to start again. Right, so I think it's because I was on the North American server and the ping went over 500, so I think it just kicked me out. No, it's gone again. Not quite sure what's going on with this. Let's try this one again. Seem there may be a bit of an issue with my tinterwebs. Maybe that's a pain. I'm not going to stop the recording because I've been trying to get this done for ages. Right, we're going to jump on this one. So I'm on the English server. It's going to be night time, I'm afraid, but the principles are going to be the same. I just want to obviously get a route done. I've got across what I wanted to do and in this episode anyway, and that was obviously to thank those three guys and talk about the cruise control that I now know. Right, let's jump on this, hopefully it'll be okay. So So obviously server stability is not 100%, as you can see there. I haven't had any issues before, so it is a first. So I'm not going to complain too much. Right, let's turn you off. Everything's going to go off. I'm going to turn the lights up. Close the doors. Cruise control 120. Wait for the power to kick back in. There it goes. And let's get going. Let's go 100% power. Beautiful, right? Simple as that, nice and quick. We're off. So yeah, obviously, slightly different look at night time. Unless you're inside the cabin. Right, how long? We've got a orange light in kilometre, so I'll keep my eyes on that. Right, I'm gonna turn the music up a bit so you guys can sit back and enjoy that, and I'll chat with you at the end unless something significant happens. Right, so we are currently here at Milan, and the scenario will end. I think I can't remember if it's at here or just after here, but it's around this area. The scenario will end, and we will get our points. Oh, what have we done there? Whoa, whoa, whoa! That went a bit all funky. Right, let's crack on. So far, I haven't had any negatives, I don't think. Not that I've seen, anyway. Do have an orange light ahead of us, so I'm going to be aware of that. We get a red on the next, then I'll slow right down. Was kind of hoping I was going to go green, but we can see a red light ahead. Bring it down to 40. Oh, there we go, we've got an orange light now. Let's bring it back up again. Hopefully the next red is going to be at this station and not before. There's no trains in front of us. Obviously something to do with the station. Yeah, red light's just at the end of the station, so that's good news. I do like how the train dips forward when it's braking. Makes that little bit of extra realism. I'm all about the realism in games like this. See, I'm pretty sure we don't go to these stations here. Pretty sure. And yeah, if you're here, and you haven't already done so, please do hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. This helps my channel grow and reach more people, and obviously hit the notification bell so you know when more videos are coming out. I'm off for 10 days, so I'm going to try and get as many videos recorded and uploaded as I can, and kind of put a little bit of a schedule on for future weeks while I'm working. Right, close the doors, get ready for departure. Right, so I'm pretty sure the next station, or just before the next station, is where the scenario ends. I can't quite remember. If I'm honest, I'm pretty sure it's when we get around about this area. I show you the map quickly. Got 160 here. Let's pump that speed up. Yeah, I think we fly through and then this scenario ends. While we're flying along at 160. Just kind of come to an abrupt end as well. Oh, there's a player. Oh no, it's AI. AI talking. I'm like, what the heck's that? To the station, let's get some speed down. So yeah, we do come to the station then, and then after that it will end. It's a weird offset station, this one's got one bit here and then the next bit's further down. Vaguely remember coming through here when I was having a little look. My mouse for a second then. We should get about 1,000 points, I think, in this scenario. Maybe. To get on quickly, doors will be closing if you're not on in the next few seconds. 3, 2, oh, you just made it on time. And here we go. So yeah, the scenario will end very shortly. And that will be the end of this episode. And the next episode, which I was planning on doing this once a week, but I think I might stick a dispatch one out midweek and then go once a week from there, because I've got a few other games that I want to put up as well. So obviously trying to spread them out a little bit. And then, coming up in June, will be Diablo 4. I did play the open beta. I was going to record it and put it up, but I thought, you know, something, a million other people are doing that. I'll wait until the game releases and start playing and recording it from there. We'll be playing with my man Sponzy and Grundy, also known as Tobbs. Should end pretty soon, from my recollection. Oh, Not sure why I'm not getting any XP for hitting the horn at the right time. That's normally the case, but... Oh, and there we go. Oh, 2,650 experience gained. Awesome source. Traveled distance of 25.41 kilometers. And if we have a look at the graph, see if we've got any... No reds. All greens, that's perfect. So no speeding offences, no arriving late or departing early problems. Everything's spot on. Cool. Well, that's it, ladies and gentlemen, for this episode. So that is a quick look at the multiplayer train driving, and like I said, next time we will be jumping into the traffic dispatcher, and it's pretty much the same. You've got various different areas that you can do your dispatching at, and they are on different levels. So like level one, this is probably one of my favorite ones to be at. It's nice and simple. You got a station, a couple of tracks, and zebra crossing, or two lots of zebra crossings. Road crossings with barriers that you have to control. So that's quite a cool one. But yeah, we will jump into that in the next episode. So thanks for watching, guys, and I shall see you in a couple of days for some dispatching. Thanks, goodbye, and take care.